The E46 required a set of brake discs in the front, and I figured it's a good time to do a big brake upgrade, but an OEM big brake upgrade at the same time. So what that entails is putting 135 calipers with a bracket that we have designed, a bullet bracket that we've designed to accommodate the 135 caliper. And then we use the CSL rotors on this particular build. Now, why is that appropriate? Because we're most probably going to be doing a CSL restoration or CSL build on our E46 M3, which is technically going to be extremely cool. So why not make a big brake upgrade with the CSL calipers? So let me take you guys through some of the stuff that we have. And the bracket is for sale currently, and we have limited amount for of these particular brackets. The bracket will be selling for 3,000 Rand for a pair. And these brackets will in essence allow you to fit 135 N54 calipers onto your E46 M3, and you'll have better brakes than a CSL. I'll tell you 10 times better brakes than a CSL. So here we have the OEM CSL rotor. This particular rotor will replace the rotor that's on the car currently. The caliper itself will be removed. You'll be replacing that with the 135 caliper, and then I'll show you guys the bracket that goes onto it. And yeah, you guys will be able to see how this particular suspension will eventually look. So these are the current brackets that we have made, and they work pretty much perfect. The offset and everything is perfect to the disc, and you can see it's one bullet piece of steel that we have CNC'd, and it accommodates the existing bolts perfectly. It even has a shim on the inside to allow for it to sit correctly, and all of these designs are purposely made so that we can make it as light as possible, made out of aluminium, and you can see where this mounts onto the actual caliper itself. So this particular rotor will sit on the car, and then we'll do that there, and we'll see how it looks. Hopefully it looks good. So with the caliper released, we'll now remove the 5mm Allen key bolts. Those are five, eh? Those are 5mm Allen key bolts, and then we'll remove the old disc. You can see how weathered and old this particular disc is, a lot of ridges. I know we're letting it hang on the actual the brake pipe or whatever it is, but that's I don't really care, because I'm going to be changing that to stainless steel pipes in any case, so I don't really care about that there. So right now it's just holding the fluid in place. With the fluid in place, Kelvin will just tap off this particular disc. So with the disc off, yes, there's a lot of rust in it there. With the disc off, Kelvin, do we have some copper slip? With the disc off, we'll put the CSL disc on, and then we'll put the rotor, that's the rotor will go on. The caliper will then fit onto here. Hopefully these two holes here line up with these two holes here, and then this should fit perfectly. So you can see the difference between the two. This is like a kind of like a floating setup on it. Mount this bad boy on. So you can see how much more bigger it is. I think it's about 20 mils bigger than the stock one. And it lines up. So the CSL rotor goes on, looking all good, clean. Put the two dowels back on the inside, and then we'll come to the moment of truth. Hopefully this is the right rotor for the right side.
The wind is blowing. The disc is turning front. The wind is blowing back.
The disc is turning front and the wind is blowing back.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna have to double check that there, because I'm busy recording.
Shows.
You know when last I heard that Omri word? And just like that, guys, we fitted the caliper on the inside, but what we did have to do was on the bracket itself, we needed to space it out, because why? This anti-rattle clip here at the back was actually causing it to touch on the caliper, so we put two spacers there. Kelvin's idea, his first good idea for the day. Yeah, and there we go. So this is a mod that every N54, I'm so used to working on N54s, every S54 needs. I think this is a really good upgrade. Kelvin, put the pads on there. Let's put the wheel on and let's see how it looks with the wheel on. Let me take a picture there, Kelvin.